And joining us now on the line is SEA Games Organizing Committee spokesperson Jerry Osias. Congratulations are in order, sir, for the successful opening ceremonies.
Thank you so much, Rain. Good morning to you and to your televiewers.
Good morning.
It was a great opening, so we are very happy as part of the organizing committee, and we are happy as a Filipino, and we are happy for our country for that great opening yesterday.
Congratulations also for all who took part in the event. What were the comments from President Duterte and Sultan Hassanal Bolkiah from the opening ceremony?
Well, the President and then His Majesty the Sultan were both happy last night. In fact, they decided to stay on even after the end of the program last night. So by our official account, they left around 9:30 or close to 10 p.m. in the evening already. And the program was finished around 8:30, 8:45. So they really had a great time. And they decided to linger on and co-mingle with the delegation's presence last night.
But of course, Attorney, even that had been marred by the controversy with the alleged taped lighting of the cauldron. Is that true? And if so, why was it taped? Do the rules for the hosting of the games and the opening ceremony allow for a taped lighting of the cauldron?
Well, definitely the lighting was real. There was, in fact, a lighting ceremony. Senator Manny Pacquiao was, in fact, there, as well as all the people present at the cauldron, at the New Clark City Athletic Stadium in the cauldron complex. The people present were also there, including the light show and fireworks. Last night, there was also a fireworks and a light show for the New Clark City complex. Now, as to the question on the timing or the taping of that ceremony with Senator Pacquiao, we would leave it up to the production crew, the director and the producers of the program, the opening ceremony program, to discuss the details of those two ceremonies, one in the Philippine Arena and the other in New Clark City. They would be in the best position to explain the production and technical considerations, whether or not there was in fact a taping which happened at the cauldron ceremony.
Sure, but of course, you would know the rules. Is it allowed in the rules of hosting the opening ceremony that the lighting of the cauldron be taped?
Yeah, well, assuming it was taped, because I'm not saying whether or not it's in fact taped, assuming it was, there's no express prohibition in the SEA Federation as to the timing of the lighting.
All right, we've also just received a report, a comment by Davao City Mayor and presidential daughter, of course, Sara Duterte, saying that it seems the opening ceremony presentation was a little bit Manila-centric and less inclusive as she would wish. Would you like to offer a comment on that?
Oh, well, I was there at the opening ceremony. I was present at the Philippine Arena. It was as inclusive as it can be because it would feature our traditional culture, traditional dances, even our martial arts, our knees. It was well represented, as well as our various cultures all over the region. I think what was posted, attributed to Mayor Sara Duterte, was the choice of the Manila song in the welcome march for the Philippine delegation. Well, because that song was representative of Manila as the capital of the Philippines, no one is disputing that. In fact, it's representative of our country because when you talk about Manila as the capital, you're talking about the Philippines. So when we welcome someone in Manila, it means you're welcoming everyone to the Philippines. So that's my opinion on that. I wouldn't want to hazard a guess on the feelings or sentiments of the presidential daughter. But I, for one, I'm not from Manila. I'm from Las Piñas and my family's from Bulacan. But I did not feel slighted or offended with the choice of the Manila song when it came to the march of our Philippine delegation athletes.
Let's see. Now, 55,000 seats available at the Philippine Arena for the largest indoor opening event. Was it a ticketed event, and who were present apart from the athletes and delegates? Of course, in attendance were about half of the SEA Games delegates, around roughly 5,500. Now, while all 11 countries were represented, some athletes were sad that they couldn't attend because the sports events were so spread out across Luzon, they couldn't afford the travel time. Did we also make considerations for these athletes and delegates?
Yes, in fact, the schedule of the opening ceremony was agreed with all 11 countries. It was planned. It's just that some athletes have early games the following morning, which is today. We have triathlon events, we have dance sport events, sepak takraw events. So as a matter of consideration for athletes, they would have to defer to their coaches whether or not they are required to attend in the opening ceremonies. It's a given practice and it's allowed. If an athlete will be told by the coach or by the trainer to just sit it out for today in order to be strong or rejuvenated for the tournament the following day, then that is within the prerogative of the respective teams of the SEA Games.
So how much of the 55,000 were just spectators?
Among the spectators, because our estimates of athletes yesterday from all delegations were more than 3,000. So all the rest would be spectators from the government, from the public, from the organizing committee. There was a lot of people. Our estimate would be, there are some seats which were blocked off by the producers so that the people inside the arena would have a better view of the program. So in terms of the number of people, we would estimate that it was not less than 30,000 last night present in the Philippine arena.
Understood. Now, there were also concerns about the photography of the opening event and the games. Is it true that only the accredited photographer and some foreign news agencies were allowed access for fear of fake news proliferating? There has been a statement already, of course, from the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines. How many has FISGOC accredited, and which one is the official photographer for the event?
Okay, well, this one we had to clarify because there were some issues on confusion as to the accredited photographers. We informed those present yesterday that if they're going to use their smartphones or cell phones, whether or not you're a journalist or you're part of the audience, then that's allowed because that's part of your personal space, personal social media space. The photographers who are carrying professional cameras, they were allowed also. We're allowed to take pictures. News crews with their news cameras were allowed to take footages as well. What we had to clarify was that since this is an exclusive broadcast, what we told those present was that they could not do broadcast-type telecast, which would run counter to the exclusivity of the broadcast provider last night. So if you take a photo or a footage to allow you to cover to make your stories and then put it in your news telecast in the evening or the following day, then that's perfectly allowed. And everyone there, I've seen the reporters present there. They were taking their photos and videos and uploading in their respective social accounts what was transpiring inside the Philippine arena.
Meanwhile, attorney, there were also concerns that nobody saw the drones that has been seen at rehearsals. Was it supposed to be for the opening ceremony or for a different event?
I'm sorry, what was that question again?
The drones, the supposed light show.
The drones?
Yes, attorney.
Hello?
Yes, attorney, the drones.
The drones in the NTC, were you referring
yes,
to that?
Yes, yes. Was it actually shown on during the broadcast or was it outside of the event?
In the studio, I did not. Well, I saw an aerial footage of the NTC and the fireworks.
Sure.
Probably it was taken by drone videography or drone photography. But when you're inside the Philippine arena, the footage of what were transpiring in the NTC or the New Park City was towards the end of the program already. So I personally, being part of the audience inside the arena, did not see fully the extent of the drone videography which was shown outside of the arena in our television set.
It seems a lot of people were really looking forward to that one. Meanwhile, the games have now officially begun. What is the hope for the remainder of the SEA Games until the closing ceremony? Are there other events to highlight?
Well, what we are focusing on now are the individual competitions in the respective venues all over the, all over Central Luzon, Metro Manila, and Southern Luzon. So we are, as an organizing committee, we are continuously coordinating with the respective competitions. We continue to hope, together with our people, that we have a good showing or performance in terms of the number of medals won, and as to the medal standing, gold medal standing of our country. And we continue to call on our people, whether or not you have been from the other political spectrum, or whether or not you're in this government spectrum, we are calling on everyone to unite, at least for the SEA Games, because this is a country effort. This is a Filipino people's effort. Not just of the organizing committee, not just of the government, but of everyone, all of us as a Filipino. We are all in this together. That's why we're saying, if we are together and united, we will win as one. We win as one.
And on that note, Philippine SEA Games Organizing Committee spokesperson, Attorney Jerry Osias, thank you so much for joining us today.